This is a controversial plant. Lantana. You can tell Lantana has multiple colored blossoms. Some have been pollinated, some haven't. And the green fruit, like right here, is toxic. Green fruit is toxic. Ripe fruit is edible. So green fruit is toxic. Ripe fruit is edible.
Well, hello there. I'm Green Dean, and welcome to my 152nd video here on EatTheWeeds.com. This time about Lantana, a rather controversial plant. I have an article about Lantana on my website. I receive hysterical letters now and then from folks telling me, how dare I write about Lantana berries saying that they're edible and that they're dangerous, etc. You know, I think the problem is they don't read the entire article. Unripe or green Lantana berries are indeed toxic. That toxicity depends upon what kind of creature you are, how old you are, how much you ate, the parts that you ate, and if you chewed them or not. There are quite a few reports of unripe berries and leaves poisoning animals, particularly the leaves. As for humans, between 1906 and 1961, there were 5 reports about toddlers being significantly sickened by eating green Lantana berries, including 1 death in Tampa. Julia Morton wrote about the plant in 1995 in this book, but did not add any more cases of poisonings. In fact, on page 80 of Plants That Poison People in Florida and Other Warm Places, she writes, quote, "The ripe fruit are eaten by natives wherever the plant grows," unquote. I have nibbled on them for decades. We sample them in my classes. To date, there have been no issues. We also know from an African study that kids eat the ripe fruit whenever it's in season, and we know wild chimpanzees eat them readily. That said, let's go take a closer look.
Well, to make sure this is clear, you know, these are Lantana berries, Lantana blossoms, and the green fruit are not edible. Just clear those, the green fruit. Green fruit is not edible. And here I've got blue and green fruit at the same time, so if I'm going to eat some of these, I am not going to eat the green ones. So we do not eat those. Well, we don't eat that those. Yeah, see? Now, when they turn metallic blue, or they look a little bit like raisins, they are edible. You know? They can be sweet, too medicinal in flavor. They can have one large seed, they can have small seeds. But there they are. Now, I have not eaten a pie of these, but a few of them are fine. I have not eaten a couple of them at a time. They're a trailside nibble, and I have eaten them for, 20 years or more. Yeah. And so it's the metallic ripe blue ones that we're interested in. Here's the blossoms, of course. Blossoms are different colors. And the leaves are pretty stinky. In fact, I think in the islands, some people use the leaves to make a tea to treat cold symptoms, which means, of course, they can be on the toxic side, so you have to use those carefully. No. And, of course, the problem is, but you can see here, I've got blue ones and green ones at the same time, because the blossom is constantly, the plant's constantly making new blossoms, and the blossoms are constantly being pollinated, and so they don't all ripen at the same time. The ripening is staggered, so you can't just pick them all at the same time, because you have to pick them individually. That's probably one of the more bigger impediments to harvesting them. Lantana berries. Quite tasty. These are on the sweet side, but they got a pretty big seed in them. But you see what I'm doing here? I'm just separating out the green ones and leaving me the blue ones and the petals. As far as I know, the petals are not edible. I've never tried them, so so I won't say anything about those. There's my Lantana berries. They're pretty common locally. In fact, there's even a town further south of here called Lantana. And there's also some man-made varieties, and I don't know about the man-made varieties. I'm more specifically referring to the wild ones, because that's my area of expertise. Oh, yeah. Lantana berries. Blue ones. Not the green ones. Blue ones. Do not eat the leaves either. If you're going to do something with the leaves, research, contact an herbalist. Lantana. Pretty common plant. Colorful. In a lot of landscaping.
Because the berries are usually eaten out of hand in small amounts, we don't have any calorie estimate for what 100 grams or 3.5 ounces have as for calories. I mean, that's far more than what I ever eat at one time. However, if we average two 100 gram samples, the fruit provides 4.1 milligrams of vitamin C, 534 micrograms of beta-carotene, which becomes vitamin A, 0.08 milligrams of B1, 0.09 milligrams of B2, 1.86 milligrams of B3. It also has 512 milligrams of potassium, 32.5 milligrams of magnesium, 48.3 milligrams of calcium, and 1.81 milligrams of iron. For an adult, that works out to be about 6% of your B1, 4% of your B2, 8% of your B3, 14% of your vitamin C needs, 15% of vitamin A as beta-carotene, 9% of your magnesium need, 10% of your calcium, 13% of potassium, and 23% of your iron need. I wonder why they have a nutritional profile for a berry that a lot of people consider toxic. Maybe it's because a lot of people in other places eat them and don't have a problem with the ripe berries. I should add that a chimp study found the fruit to be 6.69% protein and 43.86% carbohydrates. Now some warnings to keep the lawyers happy. The ripe fruit can make some people more light sensitive, and the leaves are extremely toxic to dogs, which is rather unfortunate because the plant's pretty common and dogs are pretty common. The plant just destroys dog liver. Other animals affected badly by lantana leaves include cattle, horses, sheep, goats, guinea pigs, and rabbits. Interestingly, Morton, who was a professor of botany at the University of Miami, is the one who reported the severe illnesses and one death in toddlers from eating green lantana berries. However, a 2010 study did not find that. Looking at the years 1997 to 2008, the study found 641 cases of kids eating parts of the lantana. They ranged in age from 1 to 16, with the average age being 2.5. They said, quote, let me read it to get it right, ingestion of lantana, including unripe berries, was not associated with significant toxicity. Patients who ingested unripe berries did not exhibit more frequent or more severe symptoms than did patients who ingested ripe berries or other plant parts. Most patients displayed no or minimal symptoms. Children with asymptomatic ingestions and those with mild symptoms can be treated at home, unquote. There was also a similar finding in Texas last year, 2020. 784 cases were reported, the fruit being the most common part eaten. The majority of the kids were under 2 years of age. 86.7% of the cases did not require any medical attention, and the most common symptom was gastric upset. These reports, by the way, bring up a point. Almost all poisonings involve toddlers and ornamentals in your yard, or toddlers and ornamentals in your neighbor's yard. It's when they're little kids, you know. And one of those reasons for that is children have not, whether you're bovine, equine, feline, canine, humine, When they're young, they have not learned what tastes bad or what tastes good or what burns, what doesn't burn. And so they'll chew on things that actually don't taste good or can harm them, but they don't know it. And that's why almost all those cases involve toddlers. So keep an eye on them. So with Lantana, we have dire warnings on one side of the issue pertaining to unripe berries and no modern research to support that regarding kids. Here on Eat the Weeds, let's itemize the Lantana camara. Identification. It's a persistent evergreen shrub to 6 feet high, 8 feet wide. Leaves are 2 to 5 inches long and 1 to 2 inches wide, with a rounded, toothy edge and a textured surface. The stems and the leaves are covered with rough hair. When the leaves are crushed, they smell similar to, well, cat urine. Hard to misidentify. Flowers are small in clusters, typically 1 to 2 inches across the cluster. It blooms year-round. Colors range from white to yellow, orange to red, pink to rose, in unlimited combinations. Not all one color. I mean, like, not all yellow, but mixed colors. Flowers often change color as they age. To clarify, Lantana camara has blossoms that are different colors. You know, yellow and orange, pink and red. Lantana depressa has yellow blossoms only, or white blossoms with yellow throats. No pink, no red, no orange blossoms. I have not found any references to the edibility of ripe Lantana depressa berries. Okay. Time of year. Fruit can ripen all year. The fruit, when ripe, is purple black. I call it metallic blue. You know, everybody gets a little different, but it's definitely not green. When it's ripe, it's definitely not green. It's definitely much darker. Dark blue, metallic blue, something like that. Environment. Well, I mean, it's a planted ornamental all over the place, so it's kind of hard to miss that. But when it has its choices, it likes waste places. And again, landscaping to a potted plant, it really likes full sun. It's not something you're going to find in the shade. Well, you do, it's not going to be happy. Method of preparation. The ripe berries, which some people call dark purple, I call metallic blue, are eaten out of hand. They have a flavor similar to cross between black cherries and currants. Sometimes they taste medicinal to me, and sometimes sweet. They can have tiny seeds, they can have one big seed. They vary quite a lot. They can be used to make jams and jellies, pies, and cordials. The fruit can also be used to make a light purple dye. The leaves can be used to polish wood. Perhaps a good reason not to eat them. Yeah. Some people use the leaves medicinally. Consult your local herbalist. I'm not an herbalist. That's way outside my pay grade. Thanks for joining me here on my 152nd video on eattheweeds.com. And this is about ripe Lantana berries. So until next time, I want you to think green, eat green, live green too, and sometimes that includes carefully trying controversial, ripe, metallic blue, dark blue, purple, Lantana berries, Lantana camara. Toodles.